how to get every warrior rune in WoW Season of Discovery, the Victory Rush. You will get this rune in the starter zone when you reach level 2. Go to the closest class trainer and he will have a quest for you. The quest depends on your race, but usually it's either collect a box or kill a certain amount of mobs. For undead, the race I'm playing, you go up north and collect a box. One notable is orcs and trolls, which you need to do a small jumping puzzle for and open a box. You get this rune from killing mobs and bosses around the starting area. It will appear in the first zone for every race, but for different mobs. This is also a hand rune, like Victory Rush. So because Victory Rush is better, it doesn't matter if you don't get it in the start. For this one, you need to enter a tavern on any of these locations. When you get to the tavern, interact with the innkeeper. She will need your help to get someone away from the bar. He is usually outside, in the basement, or in the main part of the bar, depending on which tavern you're in. If you really can't find him, just do /target his name in the chat. Once you find him, talk to him and he will become hostile. Do not forget he's around level 10. Kill him, then go back to the runekeeper, telling her that you got rid of him. Then she will give you the rune, Blood Frenzy. You can get this rune from killing the Wandering Swordsman, an NPC you can find in any starting area. But I would recommend, if you're playing Horde, go to Terrace Fall Glades, because there he only spawns in one place, so it's a lot easier to find him. The same thing goes for Alliance. Go to Dammaro, because he also has a small spawning area there. When you first see him, he will be friendly. Talk to him, where you challenge him to a duel. Once you defeat him, you will receive the rune, and if you really can't find him, just use the same thing, /target, then his name. You can also put it in a macro. Devastate. You get this rune from killing mobs around your starter area. Some of the mobs will drop 3 different heads depending on where you are, and you will get this one for just naturally playing the game. Once you have the 3 different heads, go to a vendor located in all of these locations associated with the heads. Once all the heads are in, you will get the rune. Endless Rage. There's a few different ways to get this rune, depending on your faction. For elves and humans, you will need to kill rares in these locations. For gnomes and dwarves, you need to kill Mogra's Store Hall until you get this battle totem. Then use the totem to challenge the elite Harem Chief Hoof. He is over here. Kill him and receive the rune. If you're undead, you will find a man in spiderweb in this cave. Free him and a lost adventurer will spawn. Kill him and you will receive Endless Rage. For orcs and trolls, you need to get this banner located here on the map. Walk over to the Alliance castle and find their banner. Click their banner, then some enemies will spawn. Kill them and you will get the rune. Quick Strike. For all the Horde players, there's only one way to get it. Go over to Ratchet in the Barrens by the harbor. There will be a goblin selling a fishing harpoon. Bite and then swim out in the water to the crashed ship. Then kill the giant shark using the harpoon. Once he is dead, he will drop the rune. But for Alliance, there are multiple ways to get it. In Darkshore, collect harpoons around this area and then use them to kill a fish named Paxnox and get it. In Westfall, kill the Fize NPCs to get Guildspan, a green hammer. Then use the green hammer to kill Murloc to get Soul of the Sea. Go to Madden statue at this location to interact with it, and then a level 20 mob will spawn. Kill the mob and get the rune. For the next runes, I would recommend being level 25. And all the runes are the same for both factions. For the first one, you need to go to Wetlands. Then run all the way south, where you will find a cave right here. Just follow the cave into the deepest part, where you will find a bird. He is level 25 elite, but you can easily solo him with some okay gear. Once the bird is dead, you can get the rune. The next rune will be found in Duskwood. For Horde, just take the Zeppelin over by Orgrimmar. To Strangleform, there you run north. When you get to Duskwood, walk over to Raven Hill Cemetery. When you're at the cemetery, go to the northwest corner, where you'll find a crypt. Enter the catacombs, and to the right, you'll find a chest in a hole in the wall. Interact and get the item. If you die on the way back, you can just respawn through the floor. Once you have the item, go to the eastern corner instead, where you will find a second crypt. And you will find another tomb. The fastest way in is to respawn through the floor. In the first right tomb, you will find a dead body sitting in a throne. Once you click him with the item in your bag, a level 25 elite will spawn. Kill him and you will get the rune. He's quite hard, so it may be challenging to solo him. Raging Blow. This rune will require you to get 3 different items all across Azeroth. On the edge between Wetlands and Arafa Highlands, there will be a small dwarf village, which is filled with level 25 dwarves. Go inside of it and enter the tavern. If you die on the way, you can simply respawn next to the innkeeper. From the innkeeper, you want to buy the Dragon Slayer's lance for 75 silver. For the next item is the Dragon Slayer's shield. You will find it inside the castle in Red Ridge Mountain. Go inside of it and enter the top floor, where you will find a boss orc. And behind him is a shield on the wall. Simply interact with the shield and you will get it. For the Dragon Slayer's Helm, you need to get inside Shadowfang Keep. Simply go there and find a group. It's a popular dungeon, so you will find a group quite easily. And behind the boss, Commander Springgable, you will find the helmet on the desk. Simply click it and get the helmet. Once you have all the free items, go to this location in Ashen Vale. Over there, there will be a gnome who you need to talk to. Hand in all three of the items. Interact with him once again, and then help him kill a small green dragon. After the dragon is dead, you can pick up the rune, Single-Minded Fury. For this rune, you need to get friendly with the Azeroth Commerce Authority or the Durotar Supply and Logistics, aka the Supply Box Companies. For either of the factions, simply run around these areas killing random mobs. Once the supply crate drops, go back to the capital and hand in the box right here by interacting with this NPC. Repeat this for about 1 hour or two, depending on your luck. Once you're friendly, you can buy the rune for 2 gold from the same NPC. Warbringer is the most annoying to get. You need 24 Hish Oil, 20 Dark Iron Ordnance, 16 Shredder Turbo Chargers. If you want to buy them from the auction house, it will cost you about 29 gold currently, or you can farm it out by killing high level murlocs in this area, farming Dark Iron Ordnance from these mobs. And for the Shredder Turbo Charge, you need an engineer to craft Shredder Auto Salvagers. Use them on these robot dudes, and then you'll get the items. But how I did it was recrafting copper ore to copper bar and selling it on the auction house for a slight profit. It took me like 1 to 2 hours a day for 4 days to make the gold. Anyway, once you have all the items, fly over to Ratchet, where you will be handing in all the items to this goblin. The goblin will send you to your faction capital. Go there, hand in your quest to your warrior trainer right here. Fly back to the goblin in Ratchet. Once you hand back the quest to the goblin, you will have to pay 3 additional gold to buy the rune. Also, subscribe to keep yourself updated when they release more runes in the future. Thanks for watching.